the catnip flower is in bloom. A close-up of the catnip flower. That's what they look like. Up close. The spike affair. Not the mint family, I think it's lemoni or lemony, L-A-M-I-N-A-E, I think. That's the flowers anyway. Of course, the cats aren't impressed with catnip here. I bought it specially for the cats and they're not the least bit impressed. They're not. Not the least bit impressed. There's a cat's paw. Looking at the catnip in the wind, slight wind. Pretty catnip blooms. That cat there isn't responsive to the catnip. It doesn't have the gene for catnip sensitivity. It doesn't. I bought it specially for those cats, that catnip. And that's the thanks I get. They just ignored it totally. All this catnip I've grown for them, all to no avail. That goes for that little ginger cat as well. It didn't respond to the catnip. Doesn't have the gene for catnip. Totally ignored the catnip. All this catnip here, all grown for those cats, and they don't care the least. They don't care in the least. All grown for those cats. Nepetalactone. That's the botanical Latin, isn't it? Nepeta or Nepeta Cataria? Nepeta. It's good to be able to identify it anyway, isn't it? Look how reddish purple the lower stems are. Quite red, aren't they? Let's do the catnip test one more time. They've never expressed the slightest interest in this catnip. Hey you. You're supposed to be intoxicated by this stuff. No, he definitely doesn't like it, does he? No, it doesn't work on him. Doesn't have the gene for it. Not the least bit interested. He's not a junkie.